Located in central California's Sierra Nevada mountain range, the Yosemite National Park encompasses an incredible 1,170 square miles of breathtaking natural splendor. Ranging in altitude from 2,000 feet to more than 13,000 feet above sea level, it's hard to believe that this tranquil oasis is just hours from bustling cities like San Francisco and Los Angeles.
Oh, I see waterfalls. Do you see the waterfalls?
Mm. Well, oh, it is what it's
directly
doing
center.
Here, I got it.
Do you see it?
And here. And the fox are right. Seen that one as
directly
well?
Directly center.
There's two.
There
two
they are,
right
two.
Of it.
Yosemite Valley itself is deeply carved into the gently sloping western flank of the Sierra Nevada, the longest, the highest, and the grandest single mountain range in the United States outside of Alaska. The canyon depth is greater than that of the Grand Canyon in Arizona. Our first foray into Yosemite takes us to Glacier Point, where we can look across and down into the canyon below, a classic example of a U-shaped glaciated valley. For its towering cliffs, spectacular waterfalls, granite domes and spires, glacially sculpted and polished rock, and beautiful alpine scenery, Yosemite National Park is world famous. Nowhere else are all these exceptional features so well displayed and so easily accessible. Artists, writers, tourists, and geologists flock to Yosemite and marvel at its natural wonders. It's day 10, and today we're heading into the Yosemite Valley. Simply stated, Yosemite Valley, only 7 miles long and nearly 1 mile wide, is a flat-floored, widened part of the canyon of the Merced River.
We have a slight detour here where the road's closed. The road is under several tons of rubble. South Merced River as it flows into Yosemite Canyon.
Bridal Veil Falls at Yosemite. Bridal Veil Fall drops 620 feet, and even in the autumn with low water levels is a remarkable sight. Here we are looking at El Capitan, the most majestic cliff in the valley, one of the Yosemite landmarks and a favourite challenge for rock climbers. Directly opposite stand the Cathedral Rocks, over 2,500 feet high. A visitor takes time to inspect the riverbed. In spring, this will be a raging torrent. We're following the mist trail to Vernal Falls. The sign tells us it's about a mile. There are breathtaking views along the way. The climb is pretty breathtaking too. Having reached the base of the falls, having been abandoned by the rest of the group, and faced with 300 steps, I decide that discretion is the better part of valour. Day 10 ends with a view of Half Dome Rock. Day 11 begins with a trip out along the Tioga Road. Its altitude is over 8,000 feet and it is only passable in the summer. Visitors leaving their vehicles to go hiking or camping must leave their food in these bear-proof storage boxes. Olmsted Point looks down on the Yosemite Valley from the east and from a very different angle. In the distance on the right is Half Dome Rock, a day's hike from here. Then we head for Tenaya Lake. Tenaya Lake was created by the Tenaya branch of the Tuolumne Glacier as it passed through the Tenaya Canyon. The outflow of the lake is Tenaya Creek, which runs through Tenaya Canyon into Yosemite Valley. The surface of Tenaya Lake has an elevation of 8,150 feet. Tenaya Lake is named after Chief Tenaya, who met the Mariposa Battalion near the shores of the lake. He protested that the lake already had a name, Piwiak, or Lake of the Shining Rocks. This original name is now attached to a granite dome to the east of the lake. Two days is not enough. If possible, we would like to revisit Yosemite in the spring, stay for several days at one of the park lodges, and really get to grips with the place.